Good morning, students. This is Harcharan Singh, PGT English from Cambridge International School, Dasua. And I hope you all are fit, fine, and healthy at your homes. You all are welcome to the e-learning portal of CIS Dasua. Students, as you know, we are reading the second book, that is Supplementary Reader Snapshots, and it has been published by NCERT. Students, we are reading The Ghat of the Only World, written by Amitav Ghosh. This is about Agha Shahid Ali, the famous poet. He was an American Indian poet who lived in US, but basically he was from Kashmir. And before his death, Agha Shahid Ali took one promise from Amitav Ghosh to write something about him after his death. And this chapter is the promise fulfilled by Amitav Ghosh. Amitav Ghosh tells that for the first time when Agha Shahid Ali spoke about his death, that was on 25th April 2001. That was a routine conversation, and Agha Shahid Ali, he was made a telephone call by Amitav Ghosh to remind him that they have to go to a friend's house for lunch, and Amitav Ghosh was coming to pick him up. That was the first time. And Agha Shahid Ali was perfectly fit. He was very active, apart from a few lapses of memory sometimes. And that was the first time he spoke about his death, and he said, "I hope the disease does not mean that I am going to die." They had a great conversation for many weeks, and before that he had never spoken about his death. And when at that time he told Amitav Ghosh to write something about him after his death, and this was a very embarrassing and very confusing situation for Amitav Ghosh, that how to respond to a friend's request like that. After that, he was very much shocked at hearing this, and it took him longer than usual to tell Shahid that all was going to be fine, and he must keep hope. The author could easily see a part of the building where Shahid lived from his study room. He said Agha Shahid Ali first lived in Manhattan, where he got his first blackout in February 2000. When he came to know that he had brain tumor, he decided to move to Brooklyn and wanted to live close to his youngest sister, Samita, who was teaching at the Pratt Institute. No matter how much the author consoled him, Shahid ignored it and began to laugh. That made the author realize that he was not joking. The author realized that he is being bestowed upon the responsibility of keeping Shahid alive through his words and not just spoken recitatives. He even quoted some of the excuses like, they have only known each other for a while. There are other writers who knew more about Amitav Ghosh than about Agha Shahid Ali than Amitav Ghosh, and but he insisted that Amitav Ghosh should write something about him. Shahid was firm on his words, but the author, on the other hand, was not very much sure of what to say at that moment when a friend was talking about his death. He could not find the right answer and combination of words to assure his friend that he would write about him after his death. On the other hand, he knew he was supposed to be acknowledged, because Shahid was insisting him. That day the author was clear as to what he should do. Then he decided that he would write something, and he started making notes of everything that they talked about and their conversation, because that record would help him write about Agha Shahid Ali. The author now tells that he knew Shahid even before they met. Shahid's work, his book in 1997 collection, that was The Country Without a Post Office, that had a very good impression on the author. According to him, Shahid's voice that was very poetical, disciplined, and at another moment very much involved and deep. Sometimes he would utter so much contemporary poetry. He never felt hesitated to speak in a poetic style. I mean, who could write about himself the line like, "Mad heart, be brave." Then Amitabh Ghosh tells us that he even used one line from Aga Shahid Ali's book, The Country Without a Post Office, in one of the article that he wrote in 1998, and that was on the issue of Kashmir. The only thing he knew about Shahid back then was that he was from Srinagar and he studied at the Delhi University at almost the same time Amitabh Ghosh was studying there. They even met each other a few times with the help of common friends, but they were only acquaintances, not friends. They only became friends when they moved to Brooklyn, where they were living in the neighborhood. They started meeting for occasional meals, and very soon they came to know that there were many things common between them. The things like, they both were very fond of Rogan Josh, Roshnara Begum, Kishore Kumar, and old Bombay films. And in this way, they started becoming very good friends. The author tells that one afternoon, there was another writer, Suketu Mehta, who also lived in Brooklyn. He also joined them for lunch. And together, they had made a plan. They had an idea of an adda. Adda, that means a gathering that has no agenda. Without any purpose, they would meet and they would talk a lot about various things. The author tells that Shahid was very enthusiastic. He was very much energetic, very happy. And every time they would have parties, they would have a lot of talking. And one day, while having one conversation, one crew arrived with the camera. And Aga Shahid Ali, he was not embarrassed, and he said that he loved the camera. In this way, the writer here wants to tell us that Aga Shahid Ali, he was very much energetic, very much happy, very much enthusiastic, that he loved talking, he loved food, he loved the company of friends. Amitabh Ghosh here tells us that Aga Shahid Ali, he was like a magician. He had the magic to change dull and uninteresting things into interesting and very funny and magical ones. He narrates one incident when he had gone to hospital with Aga Shahid Ali's brother Iqbal and sister Hena. They had gone to hospital. It was 21st May, and at that time Aga Shahid Ali had already undergone many unsuccessful operations. He was again back in the hospital to undergo a surgical procedure, and the purpose of this procedure was to relieve the pressure on his brain. His head was shaved and the tumor was very much visible on his bare scalp, that is the shaved head, because the head was shaved and its edges of the brain tumor that were outlined by metal sutures. And it was very much visible on the shaved head. In the hospital, when he was discharged, when the procedure was over and he was discharged, and one hospital escort, he was in blue uniform, and he came with a wheelchair because Aga Shahid Ali was being taken to home from hospital. So the hospital escort brought one wheelchair, and when Aga Shahid Ali saw that, he just waved him away and told that he did not need a wheelchair and he could walk. He had enough strength to walk out of the hospital on his own. I mean, he sent him back, but he did not know. He was groggier. Groggier means very weak. But he thought that he had enough strength, but he was very weak. And his knees bent, and he was about to fall after a few steps. He was trying to move, but could not move after a few steps and twisted and was about to fall down. His brother Iqbal went running and helped him back and told to bring the wheelchair, and they all were standing holding him upright. At that moment, Aga Shahid Ali bent against the cheerless hospital wall. He was standing beside the wall, and even at that moment, he was very happy. He was looking very happy, and when the wheelchair was given to him, the hospital escort came and gave him the wheelchair, and Aga Shahid Ali asked him whether he was a Spanish. When he said yes, he was a Spanish, Aga Shahid Ali exclaimed. He became very happy and told that he always wanted to learn Spanish because he wanted to read Lorca. Lorca is a very famous Spanish playwright whose one very famous play is Yerma. So Aga Shahid Ali told the hospital escort that he always wanted to learn Spanish to read Lorca. Here the author tells us that Aga Shahid Ali, he was so friendly. He was so friendly, he was so social that he always wanted to live in the company of friends and wanted to enjoy every moment of his life. He was very friendly, and there was a never-ending party in his living room. He always had parties there. Every time there would be some friends, there would be food, there would be laughters, there would be a lot of talking about here and there, about literature, about poetry and other things. I mean, Aga Shahid Ali, he was so enthusiastic, and he was so friendly. He always wanted to live in the company of friends and wanted to enjoy every moment of his life. He once told Amitabh Ghosh what he has written: I love it that so many people are here. I love it that people come and there is always food. I love the spirit of festivity. It means that I don't have time to be depressed. He told Amitabh Ghosh that I love friends, I love their company, I love that always people are there in my house, I love that there is always food, there is always a festival-like celebration, there is always a party. He said, I have to enjoy so much that I do not have time to be depressed or to be worried or to take any kind of tension. That was the personality of Aga Shahid Ali. Then the author tells us about his apartment, about his house. That was a very spacious, very airy, split level, and that was on the 7th floor of a newly renovated building. That is the house of Aga Shahid Ali, where there used to be parties always. There was a very big study room on the top floor and a wide terrace, a very big terrace that provided a very beautiful view of the Manhattan skyline across the East River. Aga Shahid Ali loved that view of the Brooklyn waterfront slipping. That was just like a ghat. That is a Hindi word that means the side or the bank of a river. That was just like a ghat that slipping into the East River under the glittering lights of Manhattan. That was the view from Aga Shahid Ali's house, and he loved it very much. Okay, students, what we read today, I'm going to explain that. Today we read, the author is telling us that on one of their afternoon lunches, the writer Suketu Mehta joined them. He also lived in Brooklyn. And they had one idea to make an adda. Adda, that is, the definition of adda is where they can enjoy, they can gather, and they have no agenda, and there is a lot of talking and enjoyment and food. They enjoyed each other and even made new plans to enjoy. Shahid, he was full of life as he was, met him regularly, and other writers would join them. Once there was a crew with camera that arrived there. Shahid, he was not embarrassed, and he told very openly that he loved camera. According to the author, Shahid was not less than a magician who could change dull and boring things into interesting, remarkable and magical. Here he tells, on 21st May, when the writer along with Aga Shahid Ali's brother Iqbal and sister Hena, they all went to the hospital to get him relieved from there, and there he had to undergo a procedure, and because he had already undergone many unsuccessful operations, now there was another surgical procedure that was to relieve the pressure on his brain. His head was shaved and the tumor was quite visible on his bare scalp, that is the shaved head. What happened in the hospital when he was being discharged? One hospital escort in blue uniform, he came with a wheelchair, and Aga Shahid Ali, he waved him back and told that he did not need wheelchair, he could move himself out. After walking a few steps, his knees twisted and he was about to fall down. Everybody around, including author, they all held him, and his brother Iqbal went to call the escort and to bring the wheelchair. Even at that time, Aga Shahid Ali was looking very happy. The hospital escort arrived with the wheelchair, and Aga Shahid Ali asked him if he was a Spanish. Even at that time, he was very happy, very enthusiastic. And he told him that Aga Shahid Ali always wanted to learn Spanish because he wanted to read Lorca. Shahid was a very friendly, very social, and loved the company of friends. That means, that is why in his living room there was always a party. Shahid once told the author that he loved the company of friends. He wants a lot of talking. He wants a lot of food, a lot of friends and their company, and he wants to enjoy every moment of his life. He said, there is always a celebration, there is always a festival-like feeling that he had no time to be worried or to feel depressed or to take any kind of tension. Then the author tells us about Aga Shahid Ali's apartment that was very big and airy. He lived on the 7th floor of a newly renovated building. It had a very spacious, very big study room and a big terrace from where the Manhattan skyline, which is across the East River, was also visible. He was extremely fascinated by the view of Brooklyn seaside that looked just like a ghat into the East River, decorated with the shimmering or shining Manhattan lights. Thank you.